Co-OpKinGz.com is Rebel Link.
And this is Squid.
And you already know what this is, so.
Back to the topic.
Yeah, back to the topic. So we're talking about Saving Private Ryan, the scene where, we already drew it up for you guys pretty well. But yeah, I do that. I think for me, one of the most, the dopest scene for me is, I love that part where fucking, what's the cat's name? The sniper?
Jackson.
Jackson, when he takes that cat out through the fucking,
Oh, yeah.
When he shoots him through the fucking...
Yeah. The sniper's got Taylor! Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I love that part.
That's a good scene, too.
And another good part, which is a huge emotional tug, is when,
Wade? When he gets shot?
No. When, the old man is at the... At the cemetery? The older version of, Matt Damon?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
At
the end of the movie, when he gets all emotional,
when he gets on his knees and starts bawling and shit.
Yeah.
After you see all that shit, dude,
then you understand.
Oh god.
You have a whole new perspective. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Like
that is true.
Big ass lump in your throat and shit. Man.
Yeah.
Very, very good.
Man.
I'm gonna cry now.
Okay, so number two, for me is The Shining.
Hmm.
By the infamous Stanley Kubrick.
Love
and
it.
If you were to ask me what my favorite director is, by far, Stanley Kubrick.
Was it Michael Bay?
Michael Bay could suck a fucking cock.
this video is brought to you by Michael Bay. Anyways, go ahead.
So yeah, The Shining.
Oh yeah.
I don't know about you guys, but this movie, to me, is fucking scary.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter how many times I watch it, I mean, I indulge myself in the story.
Yes.
And I visualize myself, like, seeing these fucking things happening in this house.
Mm-hmm.
In this complex thing.
And see, that goes to show that, you know, for something to be scary, it doesn't have to be monsters and aliens.
Doesn't have to be a dude with a knife.
No.
Or this fucking shadow just pops out of nowhere and scares the shit out of you. I mean, it could be as simple as just an eerie-looking image that could fuck with your head, you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah, it makes me wonder, like, what the fuck is going on with Kubrick? What goes through his head, dude? Like, alright, in this scene, I want a teddy bear sucking a dude off in a tuxedo. Let's shoot him. Like, what the fuck?
I share his fucking...
Who the fuck thinks of that shit?
I don't know, but I am glad... He came out with his fucking work of, with his, body of work.
Clockwork Orange.
Yeah.
I'm not going to say the other one because that's your number one, but.
Actually, no, I changed it up.
So Eyes Wide Shut?
Fuck you. it's 2001 Space Odyssey was great.
Mm-hmm.
I was going to say that was my number one, but I changed it up. I replaced that one.
What's number one?
Well, my number one is Goodfellas.
Oh, shit.
Goodfellas.
Gangsta movie, yeah.
If you were to ask me what my favorite actor is, I would say Robert De Niro.
Oh, I thought you were going to say Leota.
No, I was going to say Leonardo DiCaprio. No, but Goodfellas, I mean, I am also a big fan of the gangster genre.
Oh, yeah.
Gangsterism.
Mm-hmm.
Goodfellas.
Very good movie.
Excellent movie, man. Every character in that movie, you know,
believable.
Is very believable.
I always get that movie, and when I'm thinking about scenes from it, I always get that movie in Casino mixed up.
Yeah, I can see that. I mean, same people. It's Robert De Niro and Pacino combo. You know, I can see how you could confuse them.
But yeah, that's
same directing style, you know, Martin Scorsese and whatnot.
That's a good choice. Very good choice.
Yeah, I could watch that movie. I'll watch that movie when I'm cooking something, when I'm fucking...
Cooking some linguine?
Some fucking... Mingaros peppers. Forget about it, eh?
Get the fuck out of here.
Fuck out of here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This shit. I actually want to go back to 2001, because I just watched that again on Netflix. It's on... allowed you to watch it for free streaming as long as you have an account. And I forgot how really great that movie is.
It is, man.
And you know what? And the first time I watched it, I was totally lost on Kubrick's metaphor that he was trying to show.
And he is all about the metaphors.
Man. Oh, he is, believe me. So, if you kids haven't watched it, definitely watch it.
And just a fair warning, I mean, a good attention span is required.
Yes, a very good attention span is required. Just the opening, I don't even think anybody speaks until like a good 45 minutes into the movie.
That's the
right?
genius behind it, man. Mm-hmm. If you consider that genius, I do.
I do, yeah, sure. If you remember the whole, the civilization, what does it start? 3 million years ago?
Is
what
yeah.
Okay, so it starts off with like 3 million years ago and it's just a bunch of apes, right? And the metaphor that Kubrick's trying, at least in my opinion, the metaphor that he's trying to bring across is that monolith comes down and then suddenly the apes, or you know, one of them, he actually has a name. I didn't know this until I actually read like, on Wikipedia.
Yeah.
His name's Moonwatcher. Because I guess he was like one of the first animals to actually look up at the moon and be curious about why it's there and whatnot. And that's pretty pivotal in our fucking human being existence, right?
Yeah.
So anyways, they're all kind of like skinny and starving, and they just eat vegetation. They don't eat meat just yet. So the monolith comes, right, and after that he picks up this femur bone of a big animal or whatever.
Yeah.
And he starts banging it on the ground. And then he realizes that he could use it as like a tool to kill something, and that's
kind of a tool in general. Yeah.
And that's what Kubrick's trying to bring across. This is the first time we realize we could use something to kill something. The whole killing, another thing. That was the first time it's ever introduced. Otherwise, prior to that, we're just peaceful animals hanging out with other peaceful animals, eating vegetation. So there's this other local tribe that. They're kind of in war with, or like water, you know, the few water areas that they have.
Yeah.
And one of the main leader of their tribe comes over and he kills him. And you know, that it goes right into, it segues right into the.
Yeah, when he tosses the bone into the air.
The femur and the bone.
And then it just flips in slow motion and turns into the